I want to introduce Sean Wheeler, who's going to come up in a second. I'm just so thrilled for you to spend time with him. This man has dedicated his entire career to the work that he does. Commitment level is up here. Highly, highly committed being. Extraordinary at who he be, and extraordinary at what he does. I'm going to deeply, deeply ask you. There will be a video, but let's give him a round of applause just so he knows. Let's give him a round of applause.
Hi, everyone.
You ready? Come on over. Come back over.
Hi, everyone.
Shh. Not so fast. Ready? Whoa. Three, two, one. No, we gotta look here. Okay, I know the puppies are looking.
Hi everyone, I hope you're having fun at Transcendence. My name is Sienna and I'm here to introduce my dad. Just a couple weeks ago, I turned 10 years old. And what's cool is that my dad's been doing hypnotherapy for 20 years, which is more than twice as long as I've been alive. He's been on TV and radio a bunch of times, but what's most important to me is that we get to spend lots of fun time together. So without further ado, let's give a big round of applause for Sean Wheeler, my dad.
As you can see, I love my kid. I'm incredibly proud of my daughter, Sienna, for two main reasons. One is that she's very happy. And the other is that she's confident. I'm so charged to give this speech, I have to tell you. I had no idea before I got here that the entire day before my talk was going to be about my talk. I literally knew nothing about this agenda or what Alok was going to talk about. But what I want to share with you today is really about the importance of parenting. I struggled with self-confidence before I got into hypnosis. I had a transformation 22 years ago, changed my life. The first time I met my wife was in 1998. We were working together at CNN, and I was so attracted to her. I had a crush on her, but I couldn't ask her out. And I had good parenting, right? Like, I had a good childhood. I still struggle with confidence. So one day when I was at work, the woman who would become my wife walked up from behind me, and she tapped me on the shoulder, and she asked me if I wanted to go to an REM concert with her friend. My wife set me up with her friend before she was my wife, okay? But that's what you get when you don't have confidence. You don't get what you want. You get what the world gives you. So that's how I was, and I didn't see the woman who would be my wife for another 10 years. Wow. 10 years later, I randomly bumped into her at a concert, and we've been together ever since. And this beautiful girl is the thing that we have to show for it that I'm most proud of. So what I want to share with you today, after hearing all these stories this morning, like Alok talking about his childhood struggles, everybody up here in tears about wanting to be good enough, I want to go into what I've learned about that, because I have been doing this for 20 years, and these kinds of stories I've been hearing for 20 years. So the timing of this event is really interesting for me, because my daughter, as you just heard, just turned 10 2 weeks ago. I've been doing this 20 years. That means she was born at like the 10-year point, the midpoint of my career. And what I'm grateful for is during those first 10 years, as I was helping people with their problems, I was learning from them. During those first 10 years, what I was learning were the stories from my clients, like the source of their pain. I was helping them with whatever their problems were, anxiety, stress, alcoholism, smoking cessation. But the most commonly reported regret that I heard from clients 10, 20, 30 years older than me was regretting not spending more time with their kids. And I also saw the kids, I say kids, people, adults, 20, 30, 40 years old, who had stories like this and their pain embedded in their childhood because dad didn't spend enough time with them or because mom was abusive. And so I knew after 10 years that when my daughter was born, I knew what to do and I knew what not to do. I was so excited about being a parent because I knew I wasn't going to fuck her up. I'm serious. And so since she's been born, I have worked For the past 10 years, I've done 10,000 sessions, working only 4 days a week. When she was born, I committed to only working 4 days a week. I was a part-time stay-at-home dad. And I'd take her to the Georgia Aquarium and go out for lunch and take her to the park and play games with her and read to her. And I loved it. I have zero regrets about the past 10 years. And get this, I did a little math the other day because I've had a demand for my services since roughly 2010. I've had a waiting list of 2 to 3 months. And that means if I just chose to work one extra day of the week, I would have made X more money per year. I did the math, I found out it's about $500,000 in the past 10 years that I left on the table. And you can say, well, maybe I could have monetized that better, but I didn't, and I have no regrets about it. How many of you are parents, by the way? Show of hands, okay. And how many of you might want to be one someday? And how many of you had parents? I always get you with that one. So, this is something that has become extremely fundamental to all the work I've done with my clients in the past 5 to 10 years. So what this refers to is this is what the brain does. Okay, the brain focuses on negative stimuli more than positive stimuli. Now, where's the beautiful mother who was just crying at the microphone because she's not a good enough mom? Here's what you are doing. See, you are a good mother. I've talked to many clients just like you. But what do you focus on? What you're messing up? What you're not doing right? Right? The ways in which you're falling short. What are you taking for granted? Everything you're doing that's right. All the love. And that's most of it. And that's what all of you are doing in your heads that causes you doubt. You're looking past all the things that you do wonderfully. You're taking it all for granted. You know why? Because the stuff we do well, write this down, the stuff we do well is automated. It's automated. You take it for granted because you don't have to think about it. And what's on your mind? The stuff that you're struggling with, that you haven't mastered yet. That's called imposter syndrome. But you wouldn't be where you are if you didn't do those things beautifully well automatically. You guys follow me? Make sense? Okay. These are the three most important things in life, categorically, in surveys. Quality of life, and by the way, that's money, career, job, how nice your home is, the quality of food that you eat. But the other two, relationships and health. When I talk to these successful fathers, and that's who I'm specifically working on here, these successful men that are working 60, 80 hours a week in the pursuance of, look, it's not easy to run a business. It's not easy to be a VP. It's not easy to be a CEO. It's not easy to be a solopreneur. But the mistake that they're making is they're putting all of their eggs in the pursuance, that one basket, pursuing wealth, while neglecting their relationships and neglecting their health. Now, they came to me in my practice, not because I was putting out the message, I'm here to help you guys, but because alcoholism, because overweight, because their relationship sucks, they're on the verge of divorce, you know, their kids are depressed or anxious. And so they would come to me and I would find out, this is at the root. I have a client that I've been working with recently who runs 5 car dealerships, okay, but he cannot focus on spending time at home with his family because he's afraid if he slips just a little bit, that his competitors will pass them up. I had a client with $10 million in the bank, $10,000 of wine in his trunk when he came in for the session, right? This guy's been running his father's business for 30 years. He's in his early 60s, and the guy has a never-ending ball of anxiety in his stomach, right? Because there's no amount of money that makes that go away. Did you guys realize that? 6 figures, 7 figures, 9 figures does not turn off the anxiety because your brain will continue to focus on what could go wrong. What if I lose it, right? What if someone figures out that I'm a fraud? And that is the tragedy of this. Because what you have to learn how to do is to manage your consciousness. What I do with my clients in my practice is I use hypnosis, hypnotherapy, NLP. I use these things to help my clients retrain their brains so that what they're doing is they're not just focusing on what's wrong. They're not just focusing on what if I fail. They start to think with intent about what if it goes well, right? What if I succeed? And internally, right? Internally, I train them to, with hypnosis and suggestion, I train them to be more aware of what's good within them, right? To actually focus on those things that you take for granted. Like you are smart, you are capable. And it's funny because you guys all know this, right? This isn't foreign, right? Who doesn't know that they're smart in here? Now look, if you guys were complete jackasses, you wouldn't be here, okay? You're here because you're smart enough to invest in yourself and grow, okay? So if you ever think you're stupid, it's because you're forgetting how smart you are. So I think this is a crime because what this leads to is all the tears, all the dysfunction, all the excessive hesitation that we go through. So I want to play for you here in a moment a clip, because as I was noticing this particular client over the course of, you know, the past several years, I began working with the Loke in 2020. And at that time, my problem was actually that I was doing too well. You see, I'm a good friend of Aaron Morrison, and one day over lunch or dinner, I was talking to Aaron, and he mentioned that he'd found this coach who was really good at helping you find your ideal client. Now, at that point in time, I've been doing hypnotherapy for 17 years, right? I'd been around, I'd seen everything. And so when he said that, I go, that's interesting. Let me talk to this guy. And I just wanted to talk to Alok, right? Within like 3 seconds, I'm signing up for a 6-month program. He totally has me convinced that it's a good investment, and it was, right? And so I met with him one-on-one for 6 months. And during that time, he helped me to identify this client, this guy that I'd seen coming in, because here's the thing. I've been helping people too late. I've been helping people after they've already been messed up for years and years and years, trying to put out the fires. I wanted to go to stop it before it starts. And that means going at the fathers and helping them to be better parents so their kids don't get fucked up someday, right? I thought, and I have sympathy for the dads. I'm not trying to be hard on them. They're doing it because of fear, not because they don't love their kids, right? But it's a mistake. So Alok helped me to identify that guy. But by the time we were finishing up the 6-month program, this is during, I'm going to show you a clip from our last Zoom meeting. And this is the moment where Alok lit the fire that inspired me to finally take action, because my problem was that I was too complacent. That things were going so well for me in life that I didn't feel the motivation to do more. And so I want you to watch how Alok brings this out of me. And as you can see, it gets me pretty emotional. And I'm just going to leave it to him. I think anyone who's met with him will see Alok doing his thing here.
I'm very rarely in a bad mood or upset or dissatisfied. So that it's good because I'm happy, but it's not necessarily the rocket fuel that propels people to aggressively going, I gotta fucking make this better, you know? So I think I can look at that dissatisfaction and then dismiss it, you know, and think that's not really all that bad.
You mean men being shitty dads out there and fucking kids up all for millions of them? It's totally not a big deal. My life's good. Look, I'm happy. My wife and I, my daughter, we're happy. We're good. So what the fuck does the rest of it matter? Yeah. Right? That's not why you hired me, Sean.
This is gold right there. It's almost making me get emotional. It's weird. I don't get choked up very often, but I just had this thought of like how good my daughter has it. And a lot of kids don't.
When I see people sit on the sidelines who are so fucking capable, and they're like, but I'm good. I'm like, fuck. Yeah. Really? Well, because what about all those other kids that aren't? You know, that don't have the situation, the dad that your daughter does. And you're sitting there with the tools that could make it happen for that kid. But you're going, I'm good. You know? Fuck that.
That specialty of being the fucking CEO dad who's not there for his kids, that's where I need to go. Because it's the thing that is most important to me is my kid.
What's making you feel right now? You feel is feeling that other kid who doesn't fucking have that.
Well, that'll do it, man. You've more than earned what I paid you
for. Let's give it up for Alok. If it weren't for him, it wouldn't even have occurred to me. You know, I'm guilty of loving my child and my family, my wife, and helping my clients, which I did. I was doing a fulfilling thing for all these years, but I can do better. And that's what this is about. It's about taking it from just fixing these symptoms to going at the core. And I would love to transform all the executive fathers in the country, in the world, if I could, get them to balance their lives out. so that they can still have enough, they can still have their needs met, they can still succeed. I've built the best practice in Atlanta, doing 10,000 sessions in the past 10 years while being at home 3 days a week with my kid. It's possible. And that's what I want for these other dads. So what I would be doing for them, got to help them to eliminate the stress and anxiety, got to calm the fear brain so that they can be at home and be present with their kids and their wife. Not just be there checking their phones constantly, be present. And you've got to silence anxiety. Increasing self-confidence, so you're not worried. What if I fail? So what if you fail? Get back up and do it again, right? But they need to hear this. Create a clear separation between work and home. Inject more passion into your marriage. Make more time and better connections with your kids. This is what I want for these guys. Now, for all of you, if you're not an executive dad, all of you can benefit and thrive simply from silencing the fear brain, right? Silencing that fear brain. And that requires a bit of a deeper connection, right? That's why hypnosis is such a powerful tool. Because when you get relaxed, who doesn't know this? Are you at your best when you're stressed out or relaxed? Easy question. So when I hypnotize people, they're getting the most deeply relaxed as is humanly possible. And when they're in that state, when I feed them suggestions, there is nothing more satisfying for me than a client who was lamenting not being loved by their parent, wake up from their hypnosis session with tears in their eyes, and hug me in gratitude. And I've seen that time and time and time again. It's extremely satisfying. And so you have to understand what you're dealing with here. Remember, there's one thing I want you to take from this talk that doesn't have anything to do with parenting. It is that your brain is trying to survive all the time. That is why we need to reinforce. That is why thought patterns need to be installed. It's not knowing something that matters. I say there's a big difference between knowledge and awareness. Right? Knowledge is what you know, but it's in that vast reservoir of your subconscious mind. What matters is what you remember, what you're aware of at the time. And you have to program yourself to do that. Gratitude is not fucking essential for survival. Think about that. Gratitude is not essential. Survival is about not dying. And all of you are here. Congratulations. You have survived. But if you want to thrive, you have to think in a different way. A picture is worth 1,000 words. Now, I'm lucky enough to have a career that I'm passionate about, but I also have a hobby that I'm passionate about. My past career was in broadcast journalism, and my love back then was editing video. And since my daughter has been born, I have, like every other parent, been constantly taking videos of her with my phone. But I'm a little bit different in that every year on her birthday, I edit together this giant epic tribute to her year. So from the moment she's born until, you know, crawling for the first time, and walking for the first time, and riding a bike for the first time. I've got all of it on video. And every year I make this epic thing. And I'm going to show you guys a snippet, not the 40-minute version. I'm going to show you guys 10 years of her life in about 2 minutes. Okay? And this is from birth to the present moment. And I want you to pay attention to the lyrics of the song. I happen to find a perfect song for this that really speaks to the heart of what's important to me. That there is no more precious resource than you have than your time. And when it comes to kids, that's what they want most. They don't really care about the money. They would rather have you, their parents, giving them time. And so as you watch this, I want you to think of this is my vision for what I want every kid's life to be like. Okay? So if we're ready, are you guys going to roll it? Okay, great.
Daddy's a good girl.
Yeah.
Look out, kid, just your heart. You don't have to play the part. They're all for you. Just be true. There are things you could do that no one else on earth.
It's your shadow.
Whoa, you're gonna get
daddy.
But I can't teach you. I can't teach it to you.
Time of skin deep and heart.
give me a hug. Love your kids, everyone. Give them your time and your attention. And those of you who didn't get it, it's not your fault. You're good enough. Thank you.